This title is Original Sin, a short story. The story is about the personal past and the past behind the personal past, I suppose, and the problem that contemplating this past makes for us in our world of mobility, disorientation. The poem is in five-line stanza, rhyming A-B-A-B-B. Pentameter, except for the last line, which runs somewhat longer. Original Sin, a short story. Nodding, its great head rattling like a gourd, and locks like seaweed strung on the stinking stone, the nightmare stumbles past, and you have heard it fumble your door before it whimpers and is gone. It acts like the old hound that used to snuffle your door and moan. You thought you had lost it when you left Omaha, for it seemed connected then with your grandpa, who had a wen on his forehead and sat on the veranda to finger the precious protuberance, as was his habit to do, which glinted in sun like rough garnet or the rich old brain bulging through. But you met it in Harvard Yard as the historic steeple was confirming the midnight with its hideous racket. And you wondered how it had come, for it stood so imbecile, with empty hands, humble, and surely nothing in pocket. Riding the rods, perhaps, or Grandpa's will paid the ticket. You were almost kindly then, in your first homesickness, as it tortured its stiff face to speak, but scarcely mewed. Since then you have outlived all your homesickness, but have met it in many another distempered latitude. Oh, nothing is lost, ever lost, at last you understood. But it never came in the quantum glare of sun to shame you before your friends, and had nothing to do with your public experience or private reformation. But it thought no bed too narrow. It stood with lips askew and shook its great head sadly like the abstract Jew. Never met you in the lyric or cynical meadows when children call and your heart goes stone in the bosom at the orchard anguish never nor ovoid horror which is furred like a peach or avid like a delicious plum. It takes no part in your classic prudence or final axiom. Not there when you exclaimed hope is betrayed by this disastrous glory of sea capes, sun torment of white caps. There must be a new innocence for us to be stayed by. But it stood there, after all the timetables, all the maps, in the crepuscular clutter of always, always, or perhaps. You have moved often and rarely left an address, and healed the deaths of friends with a sly pleasure, a sense of cleansing and hope which blooms from distress. But it has not died, it comes, its hand childish, unsure, clutching the bribe of chocolate or a toy you used to treasure. It tries the lock. You hear but simply drowse. There is nothing remarkable in that sound at the door. Later you may hear it wander the dark house, like a mother who rises at night to seek a childhood picture. Or it goes to the backyard and stands like an old horse cold in the pasture.